Hey, good morning. Couldn't sleep last night because today's a cabin day. I was so excited. It's like Christmas morning. Alright, I'm back again. Just a quick day trip today. Let's see what we can get done. This pile of wood's been bothering me and it's ruining my pictures for the cover photos, so let's see if we can get it brought over to the burn pit. Check it out, guys. I got something that's gonna make a lot of commenters pretty happy. My neighbor Kim was nice enough to give this to me. Here's how nice of a guy he is. I asked him what I could do for him, if he wanted any money, if I could do anything, help him out with anything. The only thing he cared about was that when I'm done with it, he wanted it back so that he can give it to someone else. That's a nice guy right there. In fact, why don't we go say hi to him and check out his cabin? I just bushwhacked it across the stream and up the hill onto Kim's driveway. My neighbor and his best friend built this cabin out of cedars milled from the property. The cabin sits on 7.5 acres and they framed it up for $880. They finished it out for $2,000 and then they fully equipped it with everything that you see inside and out for a total of $5,000. He said that almost everything that he used was salvage, milled themselves, bought from yard sales, or stuff that he had lying around. I thought that was pretty impressive, and I really like the way that this cabin looks in its setting. He has a year-round spring that gravity feeds that tank in the ground, and he's got a dual system, so he's tied to the grid, and then he has a separate 12-volt system that he can use for water pumps and lighting and emergency backup. The cabin is actually framed up like a normal house, and the cedars and the vermiculite is just a siding that there's normal framing inside that. The wood stove is his primary heat here, and he'll also sometimes run an auxiliary propane heater to heat the cabin up when he first get there. All that cedar on the ceiling and the walls was milled right here on the site.
Say hi.
Hey, buddy. You want to show the bathroom?
Yeah, let's check it out.
There,
we'll go in here too.
And you and Lloyd built this together for $2,000 or $800?
It was $880 for the frame up. And
wow.
Then it was additional cost for the vermiculite that was used between the...
I'm running this to my main DC panel.
There you go.
That should come. That should come from the top. Negative first. You guys will be proud of me, I got some real terminals.
So now I'm making the connection to the positive side. Okay, and I got that breaker off. Okay, so now I got that connected. Next thing I'm gonna do is turn on the breaker and test both legs of this box over here to make sure that they're getting power. We're gonna jump the two sides of the panel together since it is used for 24 volt DC and we do not need two legs. Okay. All right, so we got 25.3 volts right there. And we got 25.3 volts right there. Just another note, I checked with Schneider, who makes QO breakers, and they say that any breaker that they make that's not specifically labeled line or load can be backfed. So that's what we're doing here.
Look at this. This is ridiculous. This is what happens when I work. I really need to work on this. I'm gonna spend like an hour cleaning everything up. Look at this. I just threw all my wire there. I got all this wire from all these jobs. I pull it out of places when I'm working on them and stuff and use it. I mean, this is ridiculous. I can't even walk around in here. I gotta clean this.
First order of business is to get some light going. I've got these 24 volt bulbs that I got on Amazon, and I got this cage at Home Depot. I've got some DC switches, and I've got some boxes, and I've got some base plates. These are 24 volt DC LED bulbs that supposedly take 4 watts. We'll see how they work. I've heard that they don't always hold up as well under 24 volts, even if they're rated 24 volts, so we'll see how these perform. And I got these cages not because I think I need them, but I just thought they would make it look neat. They were $4.99. I'd be surprised if that's making a contact down there. I need more light, and I really hate working with these spools. I mean, they're such a pain to work with. They knock everything over. They don't unravel. So we're gonna go down to the wall. This is also temporary. Wire this into a switch, and then I'll have enough light. Okay, so I put some ring terminals on here, and now I'm gonna try and connect them without dropping the screws. We will see what happens.
Oh, I got it started. Yes.
This guy doesn't want to come off. This is going to take so much editing. Who wants to watch someone screw in screws? Oh, damn it.
Now, I mentioned I hate these wires.
That might work. Yes. Victory. Okay. I should have pre-screwed these in a little more, huh? That's the sound of porcelain crunching. All right, let's flip the switch and hope it goes on. Yay! Look at that. Success. I got some three-wire cable here, so we're going to put from that box, we're going to put a three-way switch that can go from the front door or the back door. Okay, so I've shown a DC circuit and an AC circuit. And what I think I'm gonna do is now show you guys once everything's done and explain how it works. I don't know how much wiring you guys can watch before you get bored. So there's a lot of new viewers to the channel, and I just wanna go back and remind everyone that I don't live at the cabin, and the cabin's in a location that doesn't have any sort of building codes or inspections. Even if I wanted to do that, there's nobody exists whose job it is to do, so I wouldn't even be able to find someone to come do an inspection. I'm not a electrician. I'm actually not an expert at any of these building trades. I'm probably not capable of making a video that can fully teach you how to wire a house or a cabin, but I can show you where to look to start to learn. And what I strongly suggest is that you get a book like this and learn how AC wiring works first. And these are really good. They show you, they explain electricity, they explain what's going on in the breaker box, they show you all different kinds of circuits. And I'll put a link to this in the description, probably an updated version because this one's kind of old. And so once you learn AC wiring, it's a lot easier to learn the DC side of things. You know, there are some differences that you can learn as your knowledge progresses due to lower voltage, arcing potential, just stuff like that that you will pick up, especially if you learn solar. If you learn solar, you'll probably learn DC wiring and electricity. So again, I'm not an electrician. Keep in mind, those of you who have been watching me for a while, you know I'm not always the most organized and always do things in a logical way. So I hope you get some inspiration from this, maybe pick up some tips and tricks, but you know, keep in mind, you're learning from somebody who failed first grade. Oh, really quick story, I promise. So when I was a kid, in first grade, all I wanted to do was build with blocks and draw giant robots with guns on them. And anyway, so I got done with my first year of first grade and I failed it. And so my parents, you know, they came up to me and they're like, you know, being good parents, making it seem like I've got a say in the matter, like, hey honey, sweetie, we're thinking about having you repeat first grade, why don't you think about that, let us know what you think, you know. So I believe them that I actually have a say in this, and I think about it and I'm like, man, it's gonna take a long time to get to sixth grade and I'm not into this school thing. So you know, I make up my mind to go to my parents and like, mom, dad, I thought about it and I don't want to repeat first grade. I'm just going to keep soldiering through. It's going to take forever to get to sixth grade, and I really want to be done with this school thing. And my parents are like, well, great, because you're repeating first grade. And then my mom's like, oh, by the way, school goes to 12th grade. And I'm like, what? And, you know, I'm desperately
doing the math in my head, and I can't because I failed. You know, I'm in first grade and I failed it. And I'm like, what? That's four times longer than you said. Because I thought it ended in sixth grade. And my mom's like, yeah, and after 12th grade, you'll probably go to college. And I'm like, no way, I'm never going to college.
They got, my mom got me help. I was in Massachusetts grade school system. They did some testing. I had, you know, some processing speed problems, some order of operations, attention deficit, other stuff. I don't know. I wasn't paying attention when they told me. What was I talking about? But anyway, yeah. So use these videos for inspiration, but don't use them as a full-on instructional guide. I don't always do the right thing. I don't always do it in the right order. So thanks for watching, and I hope you'll enjoy this. And after this video, there's a good chance that I'm gonna miss an upload. I'll try my best, but I'm gonna be traveling, and when I get home, I'll probably only have 2 days to get it done. So there's a good chance you might not see me for 2 weeks. Thanks for watching, guys.